Hey guys, Alex from 7th Hour Films back again with Life on Mars. Last time on Life on Mars, we had, I think I called it Rocket Man. And I don't remember what it was called unofficially. Probably something that's generic and boring. Let's go find out. Because yeah, I don't remember actually. Oh, hello. I've had these on Discord. Someone just sent them to me. Looks like someone just... today, actually, not too long ago, someone just sent me the episode titles for Ashes to Ashes. Apparently, there's only unofficial titles for the first series of Ashes to Ashes. Well, good to know. I'll remember that, and I will use that. Now, let me go back up to where Life on Mars was. A deadly drug is what the last episode was called. I mean, well, that's not wrong. That's not terrible, but it wasn't really about the heroin. That was just what was happening. But anyway, yeah. There was a whole thing about heroin and racism and prejudice, and it all resulted in a very stupid, bad twist. But that was just the ending. Like, the rest of the episode was pretty solid. I'd say this was like a 98% solid episode. So, yeah. Yeah. Anywho, let's see what happens in this, the penultimate episode of Life on Mars. Here we go.
Does he think he is? No bugger.
Oh, are we at a court?
Court number 3 is now in.
Oh, yeah.
No. It was an accident. Mr. Haslam was trying to help me.
I swear by Almighty God that the evidence I shall give should be the truth. The whole truth.
This is interesting. I can't believe we've never seen them in court.
Chief. I know what you'd like me to say. But I know what I saw. And what I saw was him kicking 7 types of shit out of him.
7 types.
Goes it all wrong.
No. How did you drive him here, man? I mean, he doesn't know.
He'll come to you. He'll ask for your help.
Okay.
I appear to have killed a man.
My name is Sam.
Oh. That's a hell of a thing to say. I appear to have killed a man.
Because if this goes the way it looks like it's going, I want you to lead the investigation.
You need my help.
Just be the picky pain in the arse you normally are and I should be fine.
A good point. Oh man, that's fucking terrible.
But it looks bad.
But looks aren't enough to hang anyone. As the man said, it's the evidence that counts.
Who's this guy?
And you are?
Frank Morgan, acting DCI.
As acting your boss DCI? Currently
languishes in a hole.
Well, he seems very professional.
Bastard.
Duh.
That's all we need.
Oh, yes.
Just immediately.
Well, he's from Hyde, isn't he? And we all know what they're like, don't we?
Yeah.
He's from Hyde?
Actually, I've never had the pleasure of meeting your DI. Carling, when you're ready.
He's from that's extra. That's an extra thing. It's weird to see him without a jacket. Or being on the other side. Man. Not only is this guy extra, his outfit is extra.
Should be standard practice. I find it keeps everyone honest.
He really is from Hyde.
With all due respect, Mr. Merrick.
Given that you've not yet charged my esteemed client,
I don't quite see how
you have the brass to hold him as long as you have.
Put up or shut up. Taking into consideration the serious nature of the offence.
No more shall they in bondage toil and let and the my fact. People go.
Taking into consideration.
Go down, Moses.
This guy, that's exactly who Gene would get as a lawyer.
With PR in mind, I have a very special assignment for DC Cartwright.
What's the assignment?
road bloody safety.
Probably better off out of it.
No.
Well, thanks for your support, Inspector.
Ah, the Hideway.
Well, he's right, isn't he?
What do you mean?
You're both from Hyde.
Duh.
I think we're on the same track. Why don't you check up on the others, see how they're getting on? Show your face.
Boy, he is... It's so weird, it's basically...
A snail in Hunt's coffin.
Sam is basically having to fight himself. Ooh, what a great dynamic. Because he's so much like Sam that it's not good.
Keen said him to tell the first one to knock that you're a useless tosser.
Gee, thanks.
You let the prime suspect in a murder case walk right past you in broad daylight.
Well, someone's pissed.
I wasn't expecting much from this unit. But Christ. How the hell can you operate as an effective officer in a place like this?
I don't know.
Well, you learn to work with them.
Double check.
Who is this?
Now, it just looped on him.
Who are you?
You can't talk to them.
Gave me an envelope. Asked me to pass it on to Mr. Hunt. I did.
You know Gene Hunt?
Oh, yeah. He and Terry Haslam go way back. Mr. Hunt can come down and watch your training session.
Oh no, is that Annie in there? That's rough. Poor Annie.
Gene was on the take.
Damn.
It's wrong, it's all wrong.
What did he need to do? He crossed the line. He killed a man.
No, that can't be it.
You always said Gene didn't know when to stop.
I trusted him.
So did I. We all did.
Nah, come on. It's too early in the episode to have it decided.
Yeah, but...
There's Slime here!
Aw, shit.
Face it.
Okay, gentlemen, shall we proceed?
Now get out there and find Gene Hunt!
Damn. Even Ray's been turned. Now, there's gotta be some sort of screw job here.
Don't do something you might regret. What I do regret is the day you walked onto my beat. Now, you might get to be my DCI, but don't think for one minute you'll be a tenth of the copper Gene Hunt was.
Man, don't take this out on Sam.
Why did you need to talk to him?
I thought he might know who framed me.
Why on earth would somebody want to do that?
Because I didn't do what I was supposed to.
Because he did testify.
And you took his hush money.
Ringside seats, meet the fighters. Yeah, and then the odd tenner.
Backhanders.
Perks. Part of the job. Is that I put a stop to it, all of it, months ago.
Oh, really? Wilkes said he gave you an envelope.
And inside that envelope was a load of cash. Oh, and a little note. If you keep quiet, I won't be sending a letter to the chief constable telling him about our little previous arrangement.
So Haslam blackmailed you to get him off the GBH charge.
But you didn't do it.
What made you change your mind?
A rare attack of do the right thing. I didn't do it, Sam. I swear on my life.
I know.
Okay, good. Is that the future?
No!
Jesus.
Oh, Jesus, what?
It's a dream. I just had a dream.
What I call a dream involves down a doors and a bottle of chip oil.
Yeah, oh, no. That was a nightmare.
That's what you call a guilty conscience, my friend. That's me. Slept like a baby.
Until now.
Yeah, 20 stone, baby. Burps. Snores. Farts.
I do not snore.
That's the only one he goes against.
You're not the one who's going to have to knit himself a new arsehole after 25 years of aggressive male affection in prison showers. I'm coming with you.
You won't get within a mile of CID without being recognized. Unless
what? Oh god. Oh, that's incredible. Bring back whatever the hell animal this is supposed to be. He's stuck on the paws.
You see the state of this place? Ridiculously neat.
Nuh.
You know what? My scuttered instinct tells me he's even more of a bastard than I first thought.
Nuh.
That's very perceptive. For a rat.
Nuh. I love that thing.
11:45. You put a brick through the window. Haslam runs out, we drive off.
That's 11:45. But he dies at 4 a.m. What was he doing here for 4 hours?
So you next heard heading towards the house at 3:30. So let's say Haslam opens the door.
What was he doing for 3 hours?
You're waving your gun about. Haslam's body was prevented from cooling at the predicted rate. The time of death is wrong.
So he didn't die at 4.
Earlier. Haslam was killed hours before that neighbor saw you coming back. Click of the switch. Vision of the future. Yeah, I'm trying to save your arse here.
No.
All you can do is go on about this shiny new toy. Telly. Right? Lots of tellies.
Yes.
I was stood here, swaying.
Oh.
Under the impression for some considerable time. I had multiple vision, dying for a slash, bladder the size of a bloody bowling ball.
Huh.
It took 2 bottles of bleach and a can of Ajax to get your stink off that front step.
So that's a witness.
Stink off this front step. Friends? What friends?
Him that came and poured you into the back of his van. More fool bloody him. He was the one that needed help, poor sod.
Huh. Looked
like he'd been in the wars with that bandaged hand.
Bandaged hand.
I love you.
Yeah.
Whoa! Well, Davy.
You filthy swine.
Oh, yeah.
Nuh. Thank you, ma'am. You have helped literally everything.
First few rounds, you never believed David Mackay was in that ring. He had no power, no movement, nothing. Then he started to get better. By the sixth round, he'd come out of his corner like an Alsatian with a red hot poker round up his ass.
So he was trying to win a fight.
Punch. Magnificent. Great moment, great win. But it shouldn't have happened.
What do you mean?
He wasn't supposed to win.
He should have lost.
He sees you lying there in the street. Barely conscious, all he has to do is place you at the scene to shore things up.
You'll make there you go. Nah.
Let's get over to the boxing club.
Alright, good.
It's Morgan. We've got to bring you in.
Right.
Oh. Oh no.
Why don't we go to Morgan? Oh, we know. Trust him overnight. No chance.
Nah. Yeah. Ha! Nice try. I love running from the two of them. We need to get them on our side, though.
Who are you? Mr. Ott.
Do me a favor, Mickey. The usual. Put those on. Much more shit.
The usual?
Oh, shit, you're double back.
What? That actually worked.
It's an ideal opportunity.
Hmm.
You want to know what he like twisted my guts? He killed me. Pete Welks. Oh, man. Matt Connor, just sitting back and letting it happen. So I did Haslam. And I did Wilkes. I did them both.
I don't like that everyone stopped.
I'd do him again. I'm no sorry for what I did.
Didn't think you would be.
Yeah.
Come on.
I don't blame you.
I'll take over from here.
Okay.
I have a right to feel a little upset.
Nuh.
I can understand why that loyalty might have wavered. What I find somewhat harder to understand is how you miserable tossers could for 1 second believe that I could be a friggin' bastard murderer!
Nuh.
Oh, and another thing.
Yes?
I should inform you that I intend to drink the equivalent of the North Sea in whiskey tonight. So raid your piggy banks.
Nuh. Alright. He needed to get that off his chest. We're all good now.
Where are you going?
Home.
Stay.
We're having a party. Come on, when Sam is telling you to stay at the party, you should stay at the party.
You have to start with what you know. You know? What you see in front of you.
What do you see?
I see you.
Alright, this is getting schmaltzy. Up. Oh, I'm here to end your schmaltz.
Good work. We're all very proud of you.
Hang in there, Sam. As soon as we can, we'll sort this out.
Ah, shit. He is...
Bring you back home.
Ah, shit. And he's gone. Oh, man. We gotta be getting somewhere with that. Oh, God. Oh, gosh. Oh, goodness, gish. Alrighty, that was a really good episode, I must say. Real damn good episode. Now, the one thing I wanted to see was... I think it was back here. The song that they played here. Done Me Wrong Alright by The Sweet. Done Me Wrong Alright. We'll go with that for the name. That was pretty good. Let's see what kind of bogus name we used. Hold up. Alrighty. Let me get the rest of them. And okay, this one, it's not going to be Don't Get Me or Done Me Wrong, Alright. It is... Wait, I'm going to predict it's called The Setup. The Shooting. It's called The Shooting. It's just called The Shooting. It's just called The Shooting! Come on. Let's move on. Let's move on from that awful name. The Shooting. How uninspired can you be to call it something so boring? Oh my God. Okay. What a great episode. Holy shit. Like, this was a really, really good episode. Again, little on the time travel elements, which is good. Although definitely this mystery with DCI Morgan, Frank Morgan. Okay, have I seen this guy in other stuff? I wonder. No. No. Okay, doesn't look like it. Although he was in The Phantom Menace, apparently. Interesting. Okay. Okay. So, what a really great episode. What a really, really damn good episode. So, first off, we start off in court, which was interesting. I mean, honestly, that was very interesting that, like, yeah, like, almost at the end of this show, almost two complete seasons without going to court, you would have thought that would have happened a lot sooner, but no, it was now, which, that's fine. That's completely fine. It's just interesting in a cop show, we never had a scene of them in court, you know? I'm definitely thinking of Sherlock, because I don't watch a lot of other, like, crime dramas, but I did react to Sherlock, and I do remember the episode where I think Moriarty was, like, on trial, so that stuff was interesting. But yeah, that was very interesting, And the whole thing with, you know, what the hell was his name? Oh yeah, Davy McKay, having to lie, basically. But yeah, after that, but he did lie in court, but Gene didn't. Gene defied Terry Haslam, and so then that basically inspires Davy McKay to off him, and Wilkes for that matter, which is interesting. So yeah. And yeah, just the whole setup of, you know, framing Gene is very interesting. I do kind of like that. I'm trying to think of something else where they kind of did that. Did they do that on Sherlock, maybe? I don't think so. Well, I guess on Sherlock, slight spoilers, I think, and I think this was also the end of season two, where basically Sherlock and John have to prove that he didn't make up Moriarty. I think that was it. I don't know. It's been a little while since I've rewatched Sherlock, so I should rewatch it again. I should actually. There's something I could get a Blu-ray on. Yeah, I'm kind of going through this thing where after I finish a show, I kind of want to buy the Blu-ray if I haven't already. So for like Prison Break, I already bought the Blu-ray. But after I finished Breaking Bad, I bought the Blu-ray set, and I just finished up Mr. Robot today, so I was thinking about that. So I should do that. I should get the Sherlock complete series set. Yeah. Anyway, maybe I'll do that too for Life on Mars. Maybe. Who knows? Or maybe I'll see if there's a full collection for Life on Mars to Ashes. That'd be kind of nice. Anywho. But yeah, this whole thing of, you know, setting up one of our main characters. And honestly, yeah, you kind of sit here, and while you don't really think that that was the case, I mean, there was strong evidence, you know? There was strong evidence for it, which is the thing, you know? So yeah, so they had to arrest him, and Sam had to investigate it. And we also got acting DCI Morgan, who is also from Hyde, which is interesting. So I like that. That was a very interesting dynamic as well. Honestly, just the fact that this guy does things like Sam would do them, but that's not necessarily good, you know? I mean, it's a difference of, you know, it's a difference of, not necessarily methods per se, but like, I guess just personality maybe. Like, he is hard on the book for, you know, the methods that Sam does, but Sam has had a lot of development over the past two seasons, and we see a lot of, you know, how he's changed and how he's doing things differently. And yes, he does look for evidence and all this stuff, but I don't know. It's just interesting to, like, see the difference. And honestly, yeah, to see that one of Sam's greatest adversaries is someone who thinks exactly like he does, you know? Or at the very least, you know, operates like he does, you know? I guess that's the thing. I guess it's also just a difference of attachment, you know? Because this is Sam's DCI, he does trust him. He's not just a stranger. He does trust him. He has worked with him for all this time, and he has worked for him all this time, so he knows that Gene would never cross this line. Whereas DCI Morgan doesn't know Gene at all, so that's why he would be going more on that. And that's the thing, is that DCI Morgan, it's not like he had ill intentions or anything. He was trying to legitimately solve the case. It was just that he was going down the wrong route for it, you know? But that wrong route, that wrong path, that did have compelling evidence for it being the right path, you know? So yeah, but I like that with Gene saying, you know, oh, just do what you normally do. Be a picky pain and I'll be out of here, you know? And it's true. It's true. Sam had to do what he did. And it did work. It worked out. So that was really good. I did like the lawyer. That was the perfect lawyer for Gene. Like, that is exactly who you would expect Gene's lawyer to be, you know? So that was really, really good. We did have the surveillance, which did not really go anywhere. But that was funny. Yeah, that. So it was literally just that he just slipped by. See, at first I thought it was that, that they, like, let him go, basically. They lied to Sam. But no, it seems like legitimately just Gene just slipped past them. So he literally just walked right past them. They thought the meter man was only here for 5 minutes, but nope. Meter man stayed there and Gene just left. And those two are just bloody idiots, you know? So that was interesting. Let's see. And then we got the whole thing of, you know, like the whole story, which was good. Basically, it was back in the day, you know? It was back in the day when Gene was taking this stuff. But he did put a stop to that months ago, which is interesting. He put a stop to it months ago, and I would imagine that would be around the time of Stephen Warren, you know? I feel like that'd be a turning point for Gene. So yeah, he stopped doing all that, but the reason that he was there was just because he wanted to see Davy Mackay's last fight. And then it just, one thing led to another. It literally is just one thing led to another until eventually he's framed for murder. So he saw what happened. They gave him the blackmail, but he stood against it. He stood against them in court. And then after that, he was there drunk out of his mind. And that basically, he was drunk out of his mind. And then the whole thing, you know, just worked out for Mackay that he could frame Gene for killing Haslam, which is interesting. Interesting stuff about, you know, believing, you know, do you believe in Gene, which is interesting. You know, the whole thing, Sam, I don't think he did, like, he saw the evidence, but I don't think he ever truly believed that Gene did this, you know? Cause that's the thing, you know, when, Annie, when she says, you know, oh, you've said Gene doesn't know when to stop. But he does. That's the thing. He said that before. I'm thinking of last episode, actually. Last season, episode 7. The whole thing with Ray, and he says, you know, these guys, they think they're molded after my own image, but they don't know when to stop, you know? And that has been the distinction. You know, Gene knows where the line is, and he does not cross that line. But Ray and Chris, I mean, faced with hard evidence, their faith wavered, which is interesting. And the whole thing, and obviously, yeah, Ray takes it out on Sam, but it's like, but they were the ones that wavered, you know? They were the ones that wavered. I love the use of this rat costume. That was so stupid. First off, seeing Annie in that is hilarious. And then sneaking Gene in with that is also amazing. So I like that. Going back to the crime scene, I like that. And retracing their retracing everything, trying to figure out what happened. Sam figuring out that time of death is wrong because of the heater. And yeah, so time of death was wrong, so it couldn't have been Gene. And then the TV, leading Gene back to the TV, store, basically, where, that's a witness who just completely saw, he was here at this time. I had to walk over him. I had to, get his piss off the wall. Then some guy came over and took him in a van. That is a hard evidence witness right there, That is pretty good. And yeah, that leads us straight back to Davy McKay, who was told he had to throw his last match, but he didn't want to. It wasn't about the money for him. And I like how they say that, yes, he was a boxer, but he wasn't a champion. So what matters to a guy like him is not money, but pride. So, he's not the best, but he's going to do his damnedest to try to win. And he did. He started off losing that fight, but he did win eventually instead of throwing the match. And that, after that, one thing led to another until, we are where we are. So that was all interesting. And yeah, just arresting him. And then, that just completely takes out Gene as the suspect. So all that really good. And then, the whole thing with the loyalty is I thought I had your unwavering loyalty. Apparently I was mistaken. I do like how, he does have to say it. He does have to get it off his chest. It's like, you guys did, you doubted me. You turned your backs on me. That's gotta especially sting to Ray and Chris, because they turned on him and Sam didn't. Sam didn't turn on him, that's gotta hurt. But at the same time, life goes on, So, and I like how he says, whatever, hey, we're getting drinks tonight, so get over yourselves. So you move on. And then at the end, we had the whole thing of Morgan saying, oh, we'll sort this out soon, we'll try to get you back home. Now, next episode is the finale. Not only is it the season 2 finale, it's the last episode of Life on Mars. And I don't know what we're going to be doing in Ashes to Ashes, but this, I don't know, maybe this is it for... One thing I've thought about is maybe Life on Mars is the story of Sam, so maybe Ashes to Ashes is another detective or something, or... It's just another person maybe sent back in time or something. I don't know. We still don't really know what this world is. Is this just in Sam's head, or does the coma send him back in time? We don't really know. So, whatever. I don't know. I think we're going to figure things out next episode. And then maybe that will give us some insight into where we're going for Ashes to Ashes. But yeah. I don't know, but I'm very curious to find out. All in all, really, really great episode. I love it. Honestly, I guess you could classify this as a Sam going rogue episode, but, it is Sam going rogue with Gene, it's the two of them going against them. And honestly, I don't know, there was just something about it, when they're running from Ray and Chris, it's just a lot funnier, I don't know. It's Sam going rogue, but not... I don't know how to describe it. Oh well. But yeah, really, really great episode, and I'm excited to see where we are going next time. So yeah, with all that being said, I'm Alex from 7th Hour Films, and I will see you guys next time. Take care. Alright guys, thanks for watching this video. There's a bunch of links on screen. If you want to go click around to any of those, there's a playlist for all of my Life on Mars reactions, as well as another video you can click on if you want. There's also a subscribe button and a Patreon button, as well as other links in the description if you want to go check out any of those. See you guys later.